So thank you. First of all, I would like to thank Mare Forum for what I say, reloading the ship finance, because since it's been a quite long time that we didn't see any ship finance forums active in Istanbul. So I would like to thank Mare Forum, Mr. Yannis Kostas here. Thank you very much. I'm not going to bore you with the legal structures of the ship finance, but I'm going to give you a small overview on the ship finance structures, mostly on the shipbuildings and also the ship owning sites, the sectors as well. So what we see on the structures on the ship finance, on the shipbuildings, most of the shipyards know these structures very well. So installment payment based on construction schedule. So we have like five installments during the construction terms, and each stage has been confirmed by either the classification society or other third-party surveyors, and then the parties have their funds released in exchange of refund guarantee. This is the most important problem currently. The in-exchange of refund guarantee issue, which is very difficult to find, to obtain, which is acceptable by the buyers. We have another structure, it's more simple, where the shipyard has financed itself, generally has a 20% of the contract price beforehand from the and delivery. We see that there's an 80% payment on delivery. It's like the standard MOAs that we know. So what we have as a problems on these structures on the shipyards, as of today we see the problems. Installment payment based on construction schedules, we see we cannot issue refund guarantees that the buyers accept, because generally the buyers are not very cooperative on accepting Turkish banks as a security, providing security. And foreign banks, they don't issue a refund guarantee based on a Turkish bank's counter guarantee, which is exceeding more than a year. So the deposit payment terms structure is a problem where the builder doesn't have sufficient funds to build, to finance the construction from its end. And what if the buyer goes bankrupt? This is the most important question which remains unanswered. So the current solutions of the shipyards are using to find a solution. It's what we call an escrow agreement, where the buyer put the funds in an escrow and releases the funds upon completion of each stage. We have a further mortgage securing over the new ship, over the new building, to secure the installments made. And there is another solution that the current market has adopted, is that no payment until the completion of the construction at a certain stage, where they can provide a refund guarantee for only covering only for 1 year time. There is another solution that the shipping business, shipbuilding industry has found out, that to register the ownership in the name of the buyer, but this is extremely difficult due to customs procedures, where you need to provide the buyer's equipment clear, customs cleared from the buyer's name from the customs. So what might be the alternative solutions? As Mr. Gültekin stated here, we need also the government banks directly finance the buyer after the due diligence is made, during construction, and even after delivery for a long-term finance. We have in the past have seen that Exim Bank has actually made a finance to a foreign buyer for a long term, so we were happy to hear that from Mr. Gültekin that they are going to be still active and more active on the market. And we also asked for the private banks in Turkey to provide finance to the buyers during construction and after delivery, even after delivery for long terms. We know that the Turkish banks are also giving finance to Turkish ship owners who has flying their vessels up for, under foreign flags. So the Turkish banks are very well know the market for foreign flag vessels, foreign mortgages. So they have the capacity, but we ask them to give more opportunity to direct foreign investors as well. We have also builders credit, where the shipyard actually gives the buyer its own credit, either by based on long-term payments, The shipyard still has the ownership financed through either by bareboat with the purchase obligation or transfer the ownership but put a mortgage to secure its own outstanding purchase at a selling price. So long-term finance, we have a lot of problems. So I would like to ask, yes, Simon over here, where are you, my friends? Why don't you invest in Turkey? There is no German banks, no Dutch banks left to invest in Turkey for a long time. We used to work maybe 15 years ago from transactions, but nowadays we only see each other at the conferences. For Turkey, we have another problem. Most of the foreign banks still accept as a still countries for Turkey. So the current solution that the shipowning companies are using is to use local banks and leasing structure. Generally, Turkish market is not very much open to the Chinese leasing structures yet, but we have seen and we have acted in some cases where Norwegian people are, northern part of Europe are doing purchase and leaseback structures. We have private investors to sell loans for high interest. They are not banks, but they are generally the ship owners who has their in corporately raise the fund and give direct loans to the ship owners in Turkey, who has the knowledge about the Turkish market, who knows who is doing the shipping market. And we have different foreign banks. We know that they are trying to enter into Turkish market as it's a new market for them and it's an open area for them. So what we have is an alternative solutions. It's networking, thanks to Mare Forum again, for reloading ship finance in Turkey and appointing advisors for private equity markets so that they can go out for the ship owners, shipyards in the United States market or in the Northern Europe, where we see that they have sufficient funds to invest in Turkey. The other two solutions that which probably the Turkish shipping market is not very much in favor of is to accept a joint partnership with the foreign partners with a professional management. It seems that ship owners, they really like to be on the wheel and they don't want a professional management with a professional partnership structure. And for the IPO, there is no single example for a Turkish company going IPO. However, we know that in US markets, in the London market, Marshall Island companies are stock exchange on the shipping-based companies. So what's next for the shipyards? Who will be on the top list? Who has a diversity both on shipbuilding and ship repair? So the shipyards should not start only one new shipbuildings or only one ship repair structures. They should diversify their investments. And who will have the signature type of vessel building? They have a high, who has a standard high quality vessel building will be on the top list. And also, you know, the buyers are very much interested on who has a good guarantee claims handling department. You don't want to say, oh, there's a problem in my vessel, I have a guarantee claim, and nobody is answering to my phones. So what is next for the ship owners? Who will be on the top list? So according to my view, it's who can reinvent their management and operating model. So the current way of adapting to the new world is digitalization. Who can performance management? Who will increase capacity optimism? Knowledge about the world trade by using shipping data. So performance management is more on the cost saving and improving performance of the vessels. Capacity optimization is to adjust the supply according to the demand. You know, knowledge is the key. Harvesting the info obtained from multiple parties, which will allow us the decision made on the calculations made by the artificial intelligence. So the future will be based on the artificial intelligence and connectivity, where the optimizing is the decision-making system. We will see that the more management companies will use performance softwares to check what's the best not only the best route, but which is the best cargo or where to be when the cargo is ready. So I would like to summarize about some facts about the shipping industry. We see that shipping industry quickly adopted to the new environment easily. We see a lot of change in laws, regulations, technical requirements, but every time we manage to adopt this new environment. We are very cooperative with the maritime authorities. General shipping industry is very open to the maritime authorities and they try to find a solution between what they require and what the shipping industry requires. We have good relations with the governmental financial authorities, good relations with the traders, and we know that the money will always be interested in shipping. And as a conclusion, what we need on the shipping to survive, shipping requires a solid capital. Shipping firms who doesn't have solid capital is very difficult to survive. Based on only borrowed money, shipping cannot be continued. There are funds reachable for the owners who search, but we need to go out and check who is available, who wants to lend money to us. High quality is a must for shipyards, and adapting to the new technology and digitalizing is a must for our industry. So thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.